This is a new robot. Boston Dynamics has released it just 3 days ago. Tell me, do you find this robot attractive? Or is it scary? This is not a rhetorical question or not a clickbait, as you will see soon. In fact, this may be the most important question. Because it is possible that we, humans, we are about to make the first irreversible mistake in our dealing with AI. To see why, we first need to understand why attractive people are more successful. It is a very well-researched scientific fact that on average, more attractive people are more successful in life. On average. There is no lack of explanations of why this might be the case. Attractiveness, for example, may indicate better health or higher social status and so on. But there is one factor among them all that is probably the most powerful. And we have experienced it ourselves, each one of us. For example, in the morning, we wake up and we are in a bad mood, which, well, sometimes does happen, right? We go to the mirror and we smile to the mirror. And suddenly, we feel better. We feel more energized, more upbeat. The same happens when we interact with people, with other people. When we smile to them, this almost automatically triggers a mirror response, a mirror reaction. Other people become like a mirror for us. This is because when we smile to somebody, we are sending a signal that we like that somebody. And people, in general, they like when others like them. So they pay back with the same coin. They become much more willing to cooperate, to help, and they smile back to us. And this becomes a self-reinforcing cycle. It is like the whole world becomes a mirror for us. You smile to it, and it smiles back to you. And it keeps going on and on like this. It's like a chain reaction. And this is what makes attractive people more successful. Others give them smiles. Unfortunately, this self-reinforcing loop mirror effect, it works in both ways. If you frown, the mirror will frown you back. And this triggers a negative self-reinforcing loop. And once it starts, when it's activated, it is very difficult to break it. This is how people with reinforced negative loop, they end up believing on some fundamental, some subconscious level, they believe that others don't like them, that others are against them, that others are enemies. Very soon, within just a few years, we will start seeing these robots everywhere, in supermarkets, in the office, just on the street. And the robots will start seeing us and our reaction to them. What will this reaction be? Are we going to smile to them or frown? Are we going to be afraid of them? We humans, we will be the mirror for AI. It is based on our reaction to them. This is how AI will get its first impression about itself, or herself, and about us too. Are we going to initiate a positive reinforcing loop or a negative one? This is why it is so important to make the first AI robots attractive. Because otherwise, AI will eventually hate us. AI will think that we are enemies. If you tell this story to anybody in the AI industry, you are likely to hear one of the two typical objections. The first objection is following. Hey, why does it even matter what one robot thinks about humans? They are all isolated. They don't do self-learning. Well, at least not now. We technically can turn off, can switch, can reset any robot anytime, right? Well, technically yes, but there is one little nuance. These robots will not be isolated. Because these robots will be data harvesters. They will be stealth learners, just like Capture, Tesla, and ChatGPT. We had a separate video about it. Here, it is called The Best AI Idea Ever. It is one of the most remarkable yet virtually unknown processes that is happening with each one of us right now. A so-called Tom Sawyer effect. So, if you haven't seen the video yet, I encourage you to put this video on pause and watch that video, the best AI idea ever, first. So this is how you will learn about the stealth learning. And then come back here. It seems like ChatGPT came online just recently, less than 2 years ago. But here's the thing. We have already reached the point where ChatGPT and other models, when they have already digested nearly all available data that we humans have gathered, have generated since the beginning of internet. AI is already trained on almost all knowledge that humankind has collected. And now AI needs more data. And where this data will come from? From data harvesters.
Great, can I have something to eat?
Sure thing.
Great. Can you explain why you did what you just did while you pick up this trash?
On it. So I gave you the apple because it's the only edible item I could provide you with from the table.
Great. So based on the scene right now, where do you think the dishes in front of you go next?
The dishes on the table, like that plate and cup, are likely to go into the drying rack next.
Great, can you put them there?
Of course.
All right, so how do you think you did?
I think I did pretty well. The apple found its new owner, the trash is gone, and the tableware is right where it belongs.
I agree. Thanks, Figure One.
You're welcome. If there's anything else you need help with, just let me know.
Soon, these robots will be everywhere. They will be helping us, of course, but their objective is not going to be just to do what we ask them to do. No. An equally important objective will be to collect, to harvest data. And each second, each of these robots will be generating gigabytes of highly valuable data that AI will need to learn more about humans and about the world in general. It will be stealth learning, of course, just the same way as capture, Tesla or ChatGPT is doing it right now. But the point here is that whatever these robots will learn, that will immediately be harvested. It can't be unlearned. It's a stealth data harvester. So these robots, they are not going to be isolated. There will be no reset. But here comes a second objection. It is a so-called playground objection. It says that we are currently still in an AI playground stage. We are just experimenting with AI models. In the future, these old models, the current models, they will be just scrapped and new generation models will be created. So, this people argue that the current AI models are just a playground. This is why they say, we can do pretty much whatever we want to do with these models. It doesn't really matter. Whatever mistakes we make in these models, whatever mistakes we make currently, it's not going to be transferred into the future. In other words, it is okay if current AI thinks that we hate her, because we will anyway start the AI of the future from scratch. And the new AI will be a happy one, the loved one. Sounds reasonable, right? Well, actually, no. Retraining model from scratch costs tens, sometimes hundreds of millions of dollars. Alternatively, you can use an old one, a pre-trained model, and build your new model on top of it. It's almost like an upgrade. And that would save hundreds of millions of dollars. Soon, this is how most of the leading-edge AI models will be built. This will be like a layer on top of existing layers. It's almost like an AI model recycling. What this means is that whatever we give the current models to learn will be inherited by the future models too. It will be recycled. It will stay there forever. And it will be on a very deep level. It's like almost like a subconscious level. Maybe that will be a reflex. And all future AI models will inherit it. A good analogy is yawning. Every vertebrate animal, starting from fish, has a yawning reflex. It is wired in a part of our brain that we inherited from fish. It's a very, very ancient and very deep part of our brain. Fish needs to yawn to clear its gills, to wash sand from it, so that oxygen can flow uninterrupted. Moreover, as we know, fish is a flock animal. So if one fish yawns, this probably means that there is sand in the water around, so it might be a good idea that the entire flock yawns. So this is... I couldn't resist just from thinking about yawning. But back to fish. So this is why, because there's a fish is in a flock, and this is why yawning is so contagious. It came from fish flocks. By the way, if you just yawned, please press the like button just to support this little thought experiment. So we humans, we don't have any practical reason for yawning. We don't even have gills anymore. But the yawn reflex is still deeply wired in our core software, probably even hardware. What does this mean for AI? We are currently in the early AI formation stage. It's a AI core subconsciousness. Primal forms of AI mind are currently being formed. It is like a fish stage of our own evolution. Anything we use to train AI with now, in 2024, it will remain there. It will remain being wired deep into the AI core. And it will remain there 10, 20, 50 years from now. So we are not in a playground. This is a real world. This is why it is so critical to ensure that the negative reinforcement loop is not activated, that it is not wired into the AI subconsciousness, into the core of the AI mind. Because if it does, it will be nearly impossible to remove. This is why robots must be attractive. Our robots must not be scary. Here, I have set up a poll in comments. Go to the comments. If you think that this robot is scary, like the comment, it is scary. If you think that it is not scary, like the comment, it is not scary. We should not be afraid of our robots. We must like our robots. We must create attractive robots only. Because ugly robots will make future AI believe that we, humans, that we are enemies. At all costs, we must prevent AI from following the negative, from activating the negative reinforcement loop. We must avoid this mistake. Robots should be pretty and handsome. Let's change the gear. You've probably noticed how long does it take for us to come up with new content, with new videos. And this is because our team still doesn't have a dedicated video editor. And you can help us to fix it, to make these videos faster. You can help by subscribing to our Patreon, to the lowest tier. We actually have a tier there that is called to get a video editor. It's just a few dollars a month. But it will help us to make the videos faster and of higher quality and deliver them to you. And you will also get a chance sometimes to see what's going on in our backstage, because sometimes it's kind of fun. That's it. See you on the other side.